welcome to the show. Thank you. I am Maxwel Bettendorf, your host for Welcome to the Show. Everybody, thank you for joining me today. We have an amazing show for all of you today. We have, from our own Welcome to the News, Jarrod Lowe coming in on the studio today. Coming in on the studio today to sit down with me and tell me about our students here at Corvallis. After that, we have the beautiful and lovely Holly Clausen coming on to talk about her radio show and her success in the radio business. Yes, that's right. That's right. Thank you. And after that, we have the amazing Kevin Lee playing an electric violin. I'm equally intrigued as to what that is, so stick around and check it out for yourself. But before we do that, we have decided here to spice things up a little bit on the set and take a couple of our comedy writers and pit them against each other in a battle royale of comedic wit. That's right. That's right. I call this segment the stand-up stand-up. Check it out. We were just sitting here talking, and we were thinking, how great would it be if we took our comedy writers, put them against each other to see which one's funnier?
Sweet. I'm 21. I don't have any kids, thank God. But yeah, I watch a lot of Maury and all those types of shows and Dr. Phil and stuff. And it seems like there's a lot of parents that don't know how to, you know, treat their kids, or if they act bad, they don't know how to treat them, whatever. I have this plan. I think I have this set plan that'll work, that'll kind of help that out. If parents do a lot of sexual stuff around their kids to each other, you know, while the kid watches, I think that'll scar them. And life scarring events like that to kids will train them, and they will not fuck up ever again. You can just go in their room whenever they're away for like a weekend. You're in their bed, you're fucking, they walk in like, what the fuck? Mom, you know, that's my bed, you know, and then you just leave it dirty, don't wash your sheets or anything. That'll train your kid to not fuck up ever again.
All right, so if you might notice that I have a bit less facial hair than I did in the last episode, and that's for a fairly simple reason. Frankly, it doesn't really work out for me to be mistaken for a terrorist as often as I am. When I don't have facial hair, I just look like I'm a computer science major, I'm a nerd, I'm just one of the IT guys helping out. But when I do have a beard, it causes some problems, because although it has some advantages, like I look older than I am, and I don't look like I'm a high school freshman, I look my age, it has the problem that I can't get on airplanes, I can't really go out without people worrying, and I can't sit next to old white people on the bus without them getting very, very anxious. And it was especially a problem back like last year, because I was going through No Shave November, and that was getting stressful after a while, because although I started looking like I was 21 and I looked older than I am, I did not want No Shave November to end up becoming Deport Me December.
I went to buy coffee today. I had a gift card for Dutch Bros. I had never been there. I walked in there and I was thoroughly upset with my visit there. Everyone that works there, they're like gods. They're just really attractive, extremely attractive. Massive arms. The guys look like Ryan Gosling. It's amazing. The girls just don't even look real. I'm more of a Starbucks guy myself. I like to go to a coffee place where the employees look like they've gone through traumatic events in their lives. Maybe the manager, she got pregnant when she was 14, maybe dropped out of high school. I'm gonna work at Starbucks, you know, take care of my kid. She became the manager, you know. I was like, that's something I can relate to. That's cool. I'm gonna go there. Maybe they have just C-section scars all over them. I prefer that place instead of buying coffee from Candyland. Those places are just the worst.
All right, so basically, As I've discussed earlier, I'm an Indian, and something I like doing during tests is I like to sit right next to white people, and then just in the middle of the test, I like to look at it and just be like, it totally psychs them out. They have no idea how to respond to this. Suddenly, their entire view of the test changes. It could be something incredibly simple. But now, the Indian guy sitting right next to them thinks that this is hard as to do. They don't know what to do. They start looking at the test. They start examining everything. They try to figure out where the Indian guy is getting tripped up. What is wrong with this little 2+2 thing? What's the trick here that even this brown guy sitting right next to me can't figure this out? I should know how to do this. So then they try looking at what I'm doing, but I already said f, so they're assuming I'm wrong. This helps in two reasons. One, it screws over people sitting right next to me, and since I quite don't like people, it's quite nice. And the other thing is, this means that people don't copy off my exam, and so I do the right answers, and I set the curve. So it's a pretty ingenious maneuver, if I say so myself.
Are we done?
Yeah.
That was the fucking worst thing ever.
I don't know why they called us out on 6 in the morning.
Yeah, and Christopher Walken.
You know. Chris Walken?
Chris Walken.
And now.
Hey, thank you. You are incredible. So I am sitting down here on the couch, as you can see, with Jarrod Lowe, one of our anchors from our segment, Welcome to the News. So, Welcome to the News is doing good, right?
Oh, it's doing pretty well.
It's doing pretty well. Yeah, I just saw your thing.
I apologize for last week.
Yeah, I saw you got a little upset,
yeah.
A little angry. If you haven't seen that, you should probably check it out.
No, but really, though, it's a real business.
It's real business.
Yes.
Yeah, I can tell. You guys get your news and stories straight. So I hear that this week you went solo. You went solo and you went out and you filmed something out in the community to show how much the college students here know the school that they go to. Is that true?
Yeah, you see, my co-anchor wasn't around. I couldn't find her anywhere, so.
She ran. She ran after that incident.
So, you know, I just decided to go out, you know, and try to see what people knew about Oregon State.
And Corvallis.
You know, because it's a great place to be.
It's a great place to be. You guys should be here, as you already are.
Yeah, it's a good school.
So, tell me, how did that go?
Well, for my part, it went well. People didn't understand, you know, they just didn't know anything.
So you did well, but the people that you interviewed...
I did well asking the question.
...did not do well. All right, well, I am as intrigued as I'm sure all of you are, so why don't we take a second here and check out exactly what he's talking about in our new segment I'm calling the Corvallis Questionnaire.
So we are interviewing people who go to Oregon State University in the MU quad to see how much they know about their school. I'm calling this one the Corvallis Questionnaire. Do something with me? Answer some questions?
No, I gotta go, sorry.
Hey, excuse me, you wanna answer some questions? You said no, and that hurts.
I don't know, I'm not a person.
My heart is actually shattered.
I'm sorry, I can't help you right now, man.
Woo! Want to answer this question? No?
That's right, man. Yeah, good class.
Midterm? Okay, ladies. Do you know when OSU was established? Alright, man. Do you know when OSU was established?
No.
When do you think OSU was established?
1887?
Yeah. The 1800s.
Well, you guys are both wrong. 1868.
Okay. Probably 200 years ago.
So no.
latter half of the 19th century, that's all I know.
Well, you're wrong. Actually, you could be right, but the answer is right here, 1868. Do you know what the oldest building on campus is? What is the oldest building on OSU? What building do you think is the oldest on campus?
The MU.
MU, no.
No.
Memorial Union. Going with the trend of things being
well, no.
The MU.
Wrong. It's Benton Hall.
I don't like this game.
What do you think OSU stands for? Do you know what OSU stands for? Can you tell me what OSU stands for?
Oregon State University.
No,
it doesn't.
Oregon State University? Yeah.
Wrong.
What?
It's Ohio State University?
No.
Well, yeah, no, that's... Google. Oh, she's saying no. These are my Google. Questions.
Who's the current president of OSU?
I have no idea. It's a man. I know that.
Yes. Yeah.
Who is the current president of OSU?
I don't know. I have no idea.
Who's the current president of OSU?
Someone.
Someone is wrong.
Crikey, I don't remember it.
Crikey.
Whatever.
Crikey. It's Edward J. Ray.
That's it, right?
It's actually Edward J. Ray. It's, that's wrong. No, it does not.
1868, not. Is that when Oregon State was?
Is that good?
Can you show me a picture?
I wish I had one. Who's the current president of OSU?
Ed Ray.
Holy f- You are right. How big is the OSU campus?
Like square feet? Or...
And you know, whatever you think. How big do you think the OSU campus is?
Meaning miles, meaning people, meaning...
You
know,
however you interpret it. How big do you think this campus is?
I think it should start down there. Keep coming to me.
How big is the OSU campus?
Big.
It is big.
An acre?
An acre?
Yes.
How big is the campus?
30,000 square feet. Oh, that's really small, actually. I don't know.
I think that is pretty big.
That's that big?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, it's actually 400 acres.
Yeah, that's
how many students do you think you could fit into an average OSU dorm? Okay, well, how many people do you think can fit into a dorm?
At one time.
How many people do you think you can fit into one single dorm room? How many people do you think you can fit into one single dorm room?
One. Oh, like comfort?
Yeah. No, you're wrong.
Yeah.
Well, we fit like 25 in one.
Yeah. Okay.
45.
No.
129.
I mean, according to my knowledge, it's only 17 and 2/3. And 1,200 in liquid form. 17 and 2/3 if cooperative, and 1,200 in liquid form. But, okay. You know, good try. What is the answer to the next question? And what do you guys think is the answer to the next question? Hey, can you tell me what the answer is to the next question?
Yes.
Blueberries. Pink.
Pink?
Yeah.
What is it?
The answer is yes.
No, the answer was no. Well, I do like blueberries. So, you're right. So, what do you think the answer is to the next question?
42.
You're right.
Really?
Yes. Next question. Who is OSU's biggest rival?
U of O.
Wrong, it's 42. Two girls who... don't really know much about the school. It looks like you know nothing about OSU.
Yeah, just about. Okay. I got one of them.
Yeah.
He's not good.
Welcome to the show. Thank you.
Well, I see what you mean when you say that they don't seem to understand what you're talking about. You know, how could they possibly get all those ridiculous questions? I mean, they should.
I probably wouldn't have gotten those questions either.
But you knew the answer.
Only because someone was telling me the answer.
He was telling you the answer? Well, I'll tell you one thing that they will get. Our next guest coming up here, the first song that I have by Kevin Lee on his violin.
He's great.
He's great. Say it himself. Enjoy. Thank you. Hello, hello, hello. I am sitting down here with Holly Clausen.
Hi.
That's how you say your last name, right?
Clausen.
Clausen. That's right. Sitting down here with Holly Clausen. She is phenomenal, incredible, amazing radio host. Won hundreds upon ten of awards.
And
hundreds upon ten of awards. Tell me a little bit. Tell us all a little bit about your show, the one you film Friday at 7 a.m.
Our radio show is called OSU Love Talk. It is a love talk show on campus. We do it in the mornings because it kind of promotes that whole like morning radio show, talk show thing. We talk about all things relationships, all things sex, all that. Nothing is excluded from the topic. We talk about as innocent as the first date to as explicit as some sexual content that goes on. It's actually a good time. I have two co-hosts, and we just kind of talk, and we plan out our shows, and we have segments on our show, and it's a good time.
That sounds like a good time. That sounds like a good time. So you work a lot with relationships, you say?
Yes.
A lot of work with relationships. Well, for one, I would like to first say, you've won quite a bit of awards in your show, right?
I have won quite a bit of awards at KBVR in my time here. I don't know why, but we did actually.
She's just amazing. It just happens naturally.
But last term we did win Best Morning Talk Show, which was really fun and impressive for us because it was our first term really doing the talk show together and actually planning it out. So that was really like a big honor for us to have. And I think it's just you win an award when you work hard at KBVR. That seems to be how it goes.
For all of us who work the bare minimum,
if you work moderately, you're not winning.
We're not winning anymore. So again, you work a lot with relationships. So I'm guessing you know about, I don't know, this little app called Tinder.
Yes, I am a Tinder queen. I have 400 matches on Tinder. I consider myself to be a professional Tinder-esque. I am the perfect Tinderella. And I love it. I can go on about it for hours. I think it's the world's greatest app.
Well, Tinderella, I love that. Well, I have a game here for us today that involves this Tinder game.
Good, I'm so excited.
So I call this game Told by Tinder.
Ooh.
Told by Tinder. I have explained to her previously, before we started airing, exactly what this game is going to be about, so you can help me explain it. What we are going to do is we're going to take people, some real people off of Tinder. Don't worry, they're like 70 miles away. You're not going to show up on here if you're in Corvallis watching this.
Hopefully.
Hopefully not. Possibly in Eugene, because we like making fun of them all the time.
Obviously.
So we've got people from all across Oregon on here, real profile pictures, and we've taken out their names. We've left their ages. What we're going to do is we are going to build a backstory for these people.
We're basically going to complete their Tinder bio for them.
We're going to make them a better Tinder bio.
I say we're doing a public service right
here. We are helping everybody. They're going to find love after the show. So why don't we start this off? You take all the guys. I'll take all the women.
Sounds good.
Let's get started. Hit the music and let's go.
All right.
Number
this
one.
Is our first gentleman. His name is Jeremy. He's 21 years old. As you can see, he does have one mutual friend with me. As I go to click on his bio, it happens to be that creepy guy from my art class last year. What I can tell you about Jeremy is that knowing Josh, his friend from my art class, he's probably really out there. He probably lives in Eugene and he likes to not shave ever. He participates in drinking coffee on the side of the road. He doesn't like to wear shoes. He's a really interesting human being.
He's an interesting human being. Mm-hmm. That sounds like good. Does our audience like that one? Yeah? Yeah, okay, we got some good. They like that one.
I would swipe right.
I would swipe. Yeah, let's give that guy a swipe right. All right. Next, we've got Samantha, lovely Samantha, sitting on the steps of her mansion that she lives in. Sad thing about Samantha is she actually lost her vocal cords at the age of 7 and thus is forced to speak through her violin. She plays a different chord for every word, and she's got quite a beautiful voice out there. How's the audience feel about that one? Is that a good bio? Is that a better bio than what she has already?
I'm gonna swipe left.
Whoa, got rid of that! All right, who's this?
Okay, this is Adam. Adam is not actually a real Tinder profile. You can tell by the lack of face in this profile picture. He is 19, so he is a freshman. He does have a real Facebook. He doesn't have one for a Tinder, but this is a fake profile for sure.
For sure.
Swipe left.
He's just... Can you like this? This is Nurse Julie.
Ooh.
Nurse Julie, as you can tell, must be a real nurse, given,
her obvious credentials.
Her obvious credentials. She's wearing the hat and the suit. You may also notice she's got a broken hand, which sits at this nice 90-degree angle at all times, held up by this wristband, you may have noticed, on her wrist there. She just likes long walks on the beach, and she's just looking for love. Looking for love.
Like swipe left or right? She looks like she needs some help. We're going to swipe her right for this time.
Oh, we're going to give her that one. Okay. Give her that one. All right. Who's this?
Okay, this is David. David is that guy on Tinder that you wondered just how he got on the profile. He is 59 years old, meaning that he's technically 9 years older than he's supposed to be for Tinder, but they let him slide anyway. He is my dad's high school neighbor who creeps on me because he notices that I'm his daughter. I'm gonna swipe left for reasons of trying not to get assaulted.
We'll get rid of that, Amy. All right, next up here, we have Antonia, this is a woman. This is a pizza just looking for love. You know how you're always just trying to find that pizza that you love?
This is the ideal Valentine.
This is who you want to be with. This is the love of your life. Ignore the fact that this is a 29-year-old piece of pizza shaped like a heart, because it's probably moldy and expired, but who doesn't love pizza? This one.
Hey, age is just a number.
But I can never say no to those machines. All right, do we swipe left or right?
Oh, we definitely swipe right.
We're giving it a swipe right? Just swipe that one right. Awesome. Okay, next.
Okay, this is Jonathan. Jonathan is one of those funny guys who thinks he's really funny by putting his baby picture on his Tinder profile. Oh, here. Trust me, behind this image screen, he's just turned 21 years old, as you can tell by his age, so he's new to the bars.
Doesn't look it. He's got that Benjamin
Button disease. He probably gets part of it already, honestly.
He has lots of baby things.
Yeah, but he's a... Baby jokes aside, he's the funny guy. You're gonna go through the rest of the photos first, but you probably swipe right because it at least is worth a good pickup line.
This is good. It's good. All right, we're gonna step back. Now this one I'm a little confused about. This is Hannah. Now, from the picture, I'm not sure if this is a girl or a guy who just green screened himself into the front page of the Miley Cyrus Hannah Montana.
Yeah, looks pretty realistic.
That could be the real Hannah Montana here. 21 years old, a little older than what Miley Cyrus is in that picture, but he's a sweet guy, always eager for love. Would you date him or her? I guess it's a girl now, isn't it? This is good. This is transgender. We'll give him the ball. All right, we'll swipe right or left.
Swipe right.
Swipe right.
Give him a
right. Wow. Really nice. All right, here's the last one. This one's for you. It's a bit blurry, but.
Okay. Are we talking about Goofy here? Or
it looks like this is about Goofy.
This is obviously Goofy. Goofy has spent a lot of time on the TV circuit. He's been in a lot of movies. He's starred in some. He actually is really impressive.
He's an impressive resume.
He says that the only thing that worries me here, though, is that he does say that he's 21 years old, when obviously he's much, much older than that. So you might want to, like, do a little background check before you give him a swipe right, you know, look on his Facebook, something along those lines. But
now, is he good with children, or is this just a weird scenario?
I would say he's, I mean, judging by his resume and seeing that he's worked at Disneyland for so long, he's got to be good with children.
He's got to be good with children.
So that's husband material right
that's
there.
That's husband material. Well.
Yes. Baby-making potential.
Baby-making potential with Goofy. If you want a dog-human mix, you've got the right guy here.
Swipe
and
right.
That is swipe right. That is the end of our game. Thank you very much. That was phenomenal. You've got some real talent in judging people on Tinder. How many Tinder matches do you have?
I have close to 400 Tinder matches. I have only been on Tinder for about 2 months now. I consider that to be a victory in life. It's the little things.
That
little
sounds things. Like a victory. Everybody, give it up for Holly Clausen.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. It's been a great time.
So thank you for coming on. And up next, we've got Kevin Lee playing his second and last song for our show here, so stay tuned. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you very much. We'd like to thank Jarrod Lowe for coming on the show with us. And even though we had a difficult time with our students here, it's fun to talk to him. Thank you very much. Thank you also to Kevin Lee and his violin. That was amazing, amazing. And of course, thank you to our special guest, Holly Clausen, for coming on the show. It was phenomenal. Of course, thank you to our viewers and our audience. You've been amazing. Thank you very much. And as always, till next time.